All right, now let me show you a quick way to create a service in Angular. So we go to the terminal. Once again, you can switch to the terminal window, or you can press Control and Backtick in VS Code. So here we have a small terminal window. We're going to use Angular CLI to generate a service. So ng, g for generate. Previously, we used c for components. Now we're going to use s for services. Imagine we're going to create a service for sending emails. This service is going to call an HTTP endpoint somewhere for sending these emails. So let's call this email. And note that here I just add the service name. I don't need to add .service. Okay? So this generates two files for us. One is the actual service file, and the other is a spec file which includes some boilerplate code for writing unit tests for that service. So in the app folder, look, here's our new service, email.service.ts. So we have a plain TypeScript class called email service, but there is something extra here that you didn't see before. We have this injectable, which is another decorator function, similar to the component decorator function. Why do we need this here? We would need this decorator only if this service had dependencies in its constructor. For example, imagine here we had a dependency like log service of type log service. In this case, we need to apply this injectable decorator function on this class. And this tells Angular that this class is an injectable class, which means Angular should be able to inject dependencies of this class into its constructor. Now, we didn't use this decorator when defining components, because when we use the component decorator, that decorator internally includes this injectable decorator. So that's all about injectable. And by the way, note that this decorator function is defined in Angular/core library.